Hello, Awkward Deception, and welcome back to another Mortal Kombat 11 video. And now, I know it's been a couple days since Ed Boon on Twitter announced that we're going to be having further tournament variations in a future patch in the game. And I saw the Siskando video talking about Sub-Zero possible for variations, and I looked down the comments and said that no one's really talking about this. So I decided to take it upon myself to do one for characters I play. And I'm gonna do it on Raiden, since I do play a lot with Raiden's customs, so I thought I might as well do a video on possible food variations. And now I'm gonna go over is the variations that are already, the abilities that have already been used, which are Storm Sail, Electric Burst, Quick Charge, Spark Port, Electric Current. Are already been used, so those are automatically taken out. As always, we don't think they're gonna recycle moves, which I'll just make the variations feel like, you know, just a little tweaked and stuff. But they're gonna be completely new, completely different moves and stuff. So I'm gonna go over moves that have not been used. And now my first possible third variation I'm gonna go over is Joe Push and Lightning Storm. And another variation, I'll explain why I feel like these two would go better together than another variation that is in the presets. So let's go and go over this variation real quick. Now that we are in the lab, this won't be too long. But basically, yeah, you get Joe Push, which is a kind of long reaching launcher. But it does pretty good damage. You know, a super combo like this, you know, it you still get pretty good corner carry as well. Plus in the corner you get to launch him up in the air, and it does pretty good damage. And plus if you see opponents like wave dashing, they may actually wave dash into it, or you could just wait and put it out and teleport in their face and combo launch. And the reason why I feel like it is two slots because they do plan on putting this as a tournament variation, and with tournament variations, in my opinion, I feel like they're gonna be all slots will be filled. So I feel like they want to have Joe Push in there, but just have one other move left instead of having Joe Push with two other abilities, which would be kind of a lot. So that's why, in my opinion, that the Joe Push is a two slot ability. Because honestly, it's not an overpowered move. It's very well balanced. And, you know, it's just a basic combo launcher. Now, the other one we'll talk about is Lightning Storm. And the reason why I feel like this should go well with it is because with Joe Push, you lose access to his Wago straight projectile. And now, Wayne doesn't really have projectiles to work with. And he has this. Well, with Lightning Storm, you get access to an air-to-ground projectile, you get access to an air-to-air, and you also get access to an amplified version, which will do electrify, lightning strikes. Then you get an overhead, which does have a flawless block gap as well. And what you can do with this is, like, you know, do stuff like this. Which, you know, it leaves you minus, but like, you know, it's not a bad option. Like, you can do that, but check down and miss, you know, things like that. And I feel like this can go good to go if, like, you know, pro players might find some cool setups with Lightning Storm. But here's like a quick tip to make you basically neutral, which is 4-4 into it, will leave you at neutral. And at that point, you know, no one's has the advantage. You're just basically back in neutral against Celts, like maybe like Sub-Zero, who has a 6 lane down 1, but super short range. You could either do a down 3 or a down 1 and counter Sub-Zero, then you get a free, whatever. Just depends on what Celts you play against if you have faster low pokes. I may do like a tips and tricks video for this ability in the future if it is, a tournament variation in the future. Because, you know, I've played with this ability a lot and it's super fun. And there's some cool tricks to it. Now we're gonna go back into the menu and show you guys the other third variation that I'm gonna look over real quick. And here is the other tournament variation that I come up with the other moves besides Shield Push and Lightning Storm that were not used. And these are the last three abilities that have not been used. And these actually go well together, like the Super Bolt actually goes really well at Lightning Rod, which I will show you when we get to the lab. Then we also have Rolling Thunder, which is a damage over time cloud that travels basically almost full screen. But it is really slow, and it doesn't do the best damage, but it's not a bad move to use when your opponent's like no chip. It's actually pretty strong when it gets to that point. Obviously, that is the main point of the Rolling Thunder. So let's go to the lab and show you what this variation brings to the table. Alright, let's take a look at this variation and why I feel like Super Bolt in Lightning Rod actually go well together, and that's basically what happens at the end of Super Bolt. So with this variation, you ain't gonna get a big launch. So basically, anytime you do like a, you know, you end a combo like that, you do a combo like this, but you won't get big damage, and basically almost anything will combo into it. So you don't get like a launcher, like a true launcher. But after the Super Bowl, you know, you get enough time to set one of these up, and that leaves the opponent kind of jailed, so like have to sit there and block and wait for like, you know, projectile. And it also makes your projectile a mid. No, so I'll show you like a setup, like, you know, you do this. Oh. You know, the opponent can wall away in front. So I'll show you an example of what it would look like. So we do a forward wall. So the opponent will wall in front of you. And this could happen, you know, a situation like that. Now with the amplified version, the reason why I feel like this variation goes better than with preset variation that I saw, which is called Push and Gel, is that with this, no, these two projectiles go well with this move. But the problem with Push and Gel is that you have Gel Push, which you lose access to this projectile, and you only have access to this. So I feel like that preset would not work well together with this. So I feel like this is a variation that could go well together. Plus, whenever you end combos, you get enough time to set one up. Then you got Rolling Thunder, which is a damage over time cloud, obviously. It doesn't travel too far, but it's like, show you why heal. Almost full screen. Now with this one, it becomes a bigger and it moves much faster, and it travels across the whole screen, I think a little bit more, yeah, just basically full screen. But if you try to do a corner cell like this, say we have a wake up attack. Let me say, if I do like something like this, see, I have longer recovery time, so it's not really safe to do it, but you can do this. It's not ready yet. Yeah, I do that, then it's safe, then you like take some chip, and yada yada. So we're gonna go over the other preset I saw, which is called a Push and Show. Now, basically, this is a pretty simple variation. You know, you get Lightning Rod, but the problem is whenever you do this, you lose access to your launcher. See, I'm trying to do it, see? See, I got Joe Push, but then when I set it up, I cannot do it, and I only have access to this projectile to use with it. Which, in my opinion, does not make the variation feel, you know, feel like it goes well together. I just want to go over that real quick, because that was like a preset. I look at the presets for variation ideas as well. And I looked at this preset and I feel like, nah, I just don't feel like it goes well together. But yeah, that's basically it for this video. I plan on doing other characters. Tell me down below if you guys want to play online with these possible foot variations. And see it.